Hi, this is Jeff Hahn with Extension Entomology, and we're here today at Fort Snelling to talk about emerald ash borer. Now, some of you might be thinking that late winter is not a great time to be trying to look for symptoms of emerald ash borer, but actually, this is probably the best time. People think that you have to look at the canopy of the tree and watch it kind of dying back to identify emerald ash borer, and that actually probably is the least effective way of detecting emerald ash borer. Now, emerald ash borer is an exotic invasive insect from Asia. It was found in the United States in the 2000s. And it's an insect that attacks all species of ash trees. The larvae get under the bark, tunnel, and that tunneling girdles the tree. And you can die back from the top of the tree, working its way down until the tree is killed. And Minnesota, having a very large resource of ash trees, is very susceptible, of course, to emerald ash borer. And so one of the biggest challenges with emerald ash borer is knowing whether your tree has it, because it's under the bark. And so you don't really see that activity until you see dieback, and many times it's too late to do anything about it. So today we are going to take a look at how to identify emerald ash borer in your tree. So one of the first symptoms to look for with emerald ash borer, an emerald ash borer infested tree, is woodpecker pecks. Now, woodpeckers love emerald ash borers, and a really common time for them to be going after them is late winter. So we see with this tree here all kinds of activity where the bark has been pecked off, and if you look closely, you can actually see some peck holes in the bark. Woodpeckers love emerald ash borer larvae. And although they do go after other kinds of insects, when you find evidence of woodpeckers pecking at your ash tree, there's a very high degree chance that it's going after emerald ash borer. At least it's a red flag. It should cause you to look more closely and look for other evidence of emerald ash borer. We find that when we find trees that have emerald ash borers, many times woodpeckers have found them and have also been attacking that tree as well. Another symptom of emerald ash borer is the tunnels or the galleries that they create under the bark. And again, there are native insects that can be found in ash. What helps set the emerald ash borer apart is that they make this S-shape kind of back and forth meandering shaped tunnels. And other larvae that are found in ash make very different kinds of galleries. Now, part of the challenge with this is that it's under the bark. We have the convenience of having the bark removed here so we can see the galleries. But if you're looking at your ash tree, you may not be either able to or willing to peel the bark back to see it. Now, what you could do is go up and take a smaller branch and see if you can see galleries there. But this is part of the challenge. If you can find it, it definitely means emerald ash borer. Not finding it doesn't necessarily mean it's not there. It just means you're not sure at that point. Another symptom of emerald ash borer are the D-shaped exit holes. And while this is definitive, if you can find it, they are actually hard to find. And so we can take a look at one here. So when we say D-shaped, we mean it's like a capital D. It's flat on one side, which is horizontal, and then rounded on the other. And they're small. They're only about an eighth of an inch in size. And part of the problem is that when emerald ash borer first starts to attack an ash tree, it starts at the top of the canopy, and then it works its way down. And so if you're looking at a tree and you're not sure, it could very well have emerald ash borer, it could very well have D-shaped exit holes, but they could be higher in the tree such that you don't see it. Even looking at some of these trees here at Fort Snelling, they plainly are infested, but looking at the trunks, we still are having a challenge finding the D-shaped exit holes. So these are symptoms of an emerald ash borer infested tree. And these are probably the easiest things to find. Now, it's possible you may encounter the insects themselves. The adult What really stands out about it is just it's a bright emerald green color, you know, hence the name. And we do have other insects that are bright green. Talk to an entomologist or someone who's familiar with them to get them positively identified. Now, when we look at the larvae, another name for these insects are flat-headed borers. Like the name suggests, it has a very flattened body. We look at the head end, and the head is barely visible. If we were able to flip it over, you would see that it's actually legless as well. And again, just as a reminder, we do have other native borers that attack ash. They will look different. So currently, emerald ash borer is only found in a relatively few areas of the state. The Minneapolis-St. Paul metropolitan area is found in many parts of southeastern Minnesota. And so if you are in an area where emerald ash borer is known to be, you really have two choices when it comes to your ash tree. Either protect it and save it, or to remove it. Some of the decisions, the factors that go into this decision will be the relative health of the tree, the value of that tree to you. So if you have an ash tree in your front yard and you it gives you lots of really great shade and it's in really good shape, that may be a tree you want to protect and save. If on the other hand, it's looking kind of scraggly, it's not looking all that great to begin with, then you probably want to think about removing it. Now, when it comes to removing it, keep in mind that once an ash tree dies, it becomes very brittle, and then it becomes much more dangerous, much more expensive to remove. So if you're going to remove it before it dies. For more information, we have a really nice fact sheet on emerald ash borer. It's on the University of Minnesota Extension insect webpage. And you can go to www.extension.umn.edu/insects.